Hi, welcome to Wedding Cakes for You Cake Tutorials on YouTube. So, wow, I have two people here. Woo! Thank you so much for being here. So, let me know who you are. Oh, Sol. Hi, Sol. Oh, you've been waiting. That's awesome. Thank you so much. So, today I'm going to do the beginnings of a wedding cake. I've got a 14, 10, and a 6, and I've got lemon curd filling that I made. Here's the lemon curd. And I made two batches of this, and for now I have two batches of my Italian meringue buttercream. So I'm going to start by, this is an orange cake with lemon filling. So what I'm going to do is take some of the lemon curd, put it into the buttercream, stir it around, get it nice and mixed, and then I'm going to put it in the layers, and then I'm going to add some more lemon curd. So I want this to be really lemony, and I'm going to share with you how I do that. So I'm just going to wait for a few more people to come on. Thank you so much for coming today. I appreciate it. Oh, before I get started on my cake, I want to show you, I don't know if you're on Facebook or not, but I did a Facebook Live yesterday, and I did this, started this cake behind me. It's really pretty. This is a little sneak peek. I'll bring it up to the camera so you can see it. So this will be Monday's upload and tutorial. This is the first time I've ever done the stripes, and I think they came out really nice. I'm so excited about this cake. This is a baby shower cake. It's not completely 100% done yet. I still need to put some baby booties on there and also maybe a little anchor because it's a nautical theme. So I did the stripes with this tool here. You've probably seen similar tools. This one here is actually a prototype that my son Jonathan made for me. Specifically, I wanted certain dimensions, and he also put a little holder here so I could hang it if I wanted to. And it worked really, really nice. So I'm thinking about getting these made and maybe have my logo on it or something like that. So if you guys are interested, let me know. All right, I'm gonna get started with the wedding cake. So what I have here is the buttercream, the lemon curd. This is a lemon and lemon filling. And then the cake itself is an orange cake. So here's the orange cake. I've already glued it on with some hot glue. That's the first thing I do. This is my layer. I have three layers for this cake. This is the orange cake. This is actually, it's vanilla cake, but it's made with orange juice instead of milk. And I have that in my book in case you want to try it out. So what I'm going to do actually is, first thing I'm going to do is move this out of the way for a second because I need to mix my lemon curd. So I'm going to put, I'm going to start with about a cup of the lemon curd. And this is about 4 cups of icing. This is Italian meringue. And I do have that recipe right here on YouTube. You can check it out. The link is below. And I'm gonna measure, I usually just do it to taste, but I'm gonna measure it in case you guys decide you wanna try this. So I'm putting 1 cup's worth of lemon curd into my buttercream. And the reason I'm putting it into the buttercream instead of just putting it into the cake is because it's very, very slippery and the cake will slide around. Even with a dam, sometimes this stuff is a little risky. So I choose to mix it into my buttercream. And then I use a combination of the lemon buttercream and I swirl in more lemon curd because I want this to be very lemony. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask and I can come back to them and answer you. Now I'm gonna have to try a little bit of that. Okay, that's good. So it's not super strong, but it's strong enough because I know I'm going to be swirling in the other stuff. Do you guys have any questions? Thanks for the likes, guys. All right, I'm going to point it back down again, and I'll check the questions. Let me get my turntable. My turntable, which I got at the Goodwill. It's just one of those Lazy Susans. I love this. And then the tape goes on top of that. And I normally put one of these down just to hold the cake a little bit better in place. Hopefully you can see that okay. Just gonna go ahead and put that right in there. This is a 14-inch cake, so I'm gonna use a lot of buttercream on this cake. This cake will probably take about 4 to 5 batches. So I'm leaving kind of a ridge here. Normally I'd pipe a dam, but don't really need a dam because I'm going to be using the buttercream. Then I would take the lemon curd and swirl that right in there. Another thing that goes really well with this, if you want to make a nice flavor combination, I do it a lot, is the raspberries. So what I'm going to do is, just to be safe, extra safe, I'm going to add a little more lemon curd. I want to really make sure that this lemon comes across. And if I have extra lemon curd, I will be giving that to the caterers so they can actually serve it on the side. And then what I'm going to do is just take more buttercream. Just to make sure that my next layer sticks. And I'm just going to swirl it around a little bit. Okay, so the next layer. Hold on, guys. I got to run to my freezer to get the other layer. So I just got some kittens, and they're pretty playful. And every time I open the freezer, they try to get in there. Gotta be so careful. So here's my next layer. I work with frozen cakes because it's so much easier, and also it does keep them fresher, believe it or not. When I first started coming online, a lot of people kind of didn't like the idea that I froze my cakes, and now it seems to be more accepted. I see people talking about it everywhere. It doesn't dry out the cakes, unless, of course, they're in there for months, in which case, you know, I wouldn't recommend that. So these cakes were baked on Monday. I'm going to go ahead and put it top side down. I want this to be nice and flat here. And then I'm going to repeat that whole process. I'll do one more. I'm going to use up this buttercream here.
right up to the edges. And then the lemon curd. If you haven't tried the lemon curd, give it a try. It's so good. You can make pies. You just make pie shells and fill it with lemon curd. You can use them for tartlets. You can use them to fill cupcakes. You can use it in the wedding cake like this. You can even, like, if you really want to be decadent, put it on your toast in the morning. It's so good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make more of the lemon buttercream. This is going to go to the side. And I'm going to take my second batch. And that's about a cup, so I'm going to put that right in there. Maybe a little more than a cup. So it helps to stick the buttercream in the microwave to get it soft. And I think I'm going to go ahead and do that because this is a little not hard, but it could be a little softer. Now you can, a little tip here, you can actually put this bowl in the microwave as long as you have a big enough microwave and it doesn't touch the sides. See how it's a little stiff? I'm going to go ahead and stick that in the microwave for 20 seconds. And if you guys have any questions, you can go ahead and ask me now if you want. Unable to connect to chat. It's telling me that I'm not able to connect. Let me just try to say something here. Okay, that worked. Would somebody type in the chat, because it says it's not working, but I want to see if that's correct. Because if that's the case, you might be trying to chat and I can't see it. I only see two, and that's from Sol Sastre. Technical difficulties. I can't see anything in the chat. So after I'm done here, I will come back in and see if I can see if you guys have comments. You can always comment below the video if you want. And here's my buttercream. It's a little softer. Yeah, don't be afraid to pop it right in the microwave. 10-second intervals just to make sure that you don't overdo it. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to go ahead and do this layer. And I'm going to swirl this in a little more. Oh, my buttercream's already gotten hard, so I'm just going to leave it. And I am going to put it right into my bag. This cake is for Sunday. I like to get my cakes done early in the week and by like Thursday, if I can. Friday at the latest, and then deal with all the delivery and all that on Saturday and Sunday. So I am going to go ahead and put a little bit of a lip here. And then just wait. layer, I'm gonna grab make sure no kittens are in there. One thing when you wrap your cakes in the saran wrap, when you take it off, pay close attention because sometimes it can tear and a little piece of plastic might get left behind and you don't want that ever to happen. So final layers going on. I like the flat top, so I'm gonna turn it over and just make sure it's nice and flat. That is looking really good. Now, because the cakes are cold, it will harden up everything, which makes it nice and easy to work with. And I'm just gonna put that aside for now. And I still don't see anything in the chat. Well, I don't know. I imagined you guys were chatting and I can't see it. Let me just try clicking on something else here. No, it's not working. So I guess I'm gonna probably end the demo now because I can't see any of the chat. So after I finish, I will come back and look at any comments if you guys have any underneath the video or on the side if there's any there. And before I leave, I wanted to just share really quick. In case you don't know, I have a book, Wedding Cakes with Lorelie Step by Step, and this is really a basic book, but it's got all my best recipes, and if you don't know how to make wedding cake, this is really going to help you. All right, you guys, I'm going to say goodbye, so I will see you. I'm going to be doing once a month in general here and once a month on Facebook, maybe twice if I have some special event coming up. And it's just once a week was too much for me. I couldn't handle all that plus everything else. So once a month, and it'll make it more special too. So in the meantime, I will see you every week doing the uploads and in the community. If you're not already in the community, we can chat there too. All right. So I'll see you soon. Thank you so much. And also stay tuned. Monday is the baby shower cake. And then the wedding cake will be probably the following week. Or maybe I'll do two in 1 week. We'll see. Thank you guys. Sorry about the chat. See you soon. Bye-bye.